So day one was a good show, and day two was okay. Day three was excellent. Day four blew my mind with two insane matches. We had incredible matches on day four. We had the tables match was on, well, the tables were on fire. Then we had Monster versus Monster. Today we had GTS Food in the Fridge, money on the line, and we had a hardcore championship on the line. And I have to say this was bad. This show is horrible. I'll explain why right now. So pretty much we have no good superstars. We don't even have freaking Tommy Salami. He said he was going to be in it, and Tommy Salami is not even here. And where the hell is Tommy Salami? Tommy Salami's not even in this. Where the fuck is he? Oh, he didn't show up. Yeah, but I thought you would have like surprises and everything else. So pretty much we had back and forth going. We had Blue Jack and Moses beating up on each other. We had pretty much we had Buster trying to grab going for the ladder and everything else. Rhett Titus showed up drunk. He forgot he had the match. He goes, "Who is Moses?" He no remembers who Moses is. He can't remember the fact where he's seen him from. And as Moses says that he worked as a security for all his life, and Rhett Titus goes, "Oh yeah, you were," and then he gets hit in the face, and pretty much we had Blue Jack send Moses into the ladder. Blue Jack had two sheetrocks, sent him in the corner. He even went through one. He sent once somebody through the sheetrock as well. We had uppercuts all over the place. We had staple guns to the face, the back, to the nipple, and everything else. DDT Hollywood has a chair, puts chair to Rhett's ribs. A big boot in the corner, face first to the chair by Rhett to Moses. Oh yeah, we had beer pong. Pretty much Rhett put cups on the table, was not standing up well. So pretty much Rhett had everyone have beer with him. I think it was apple juice in it, so pretty much I think it was apple juice. It kind of looks at like apple juice. It could be beer. Who knows what it could have been. It could have been apple juice. Who knows, it could have been piss too. We had so Rhett Titus decided, after Grimm told him to turn around, there's Buster going up the ladder. We had Buster and what's his name there? I just said his name. Rhett Titus on a ladder trading blows. Pretty much Buster throws him, punches him off the ladder into the table. And pretty much Hollywood Hooligan would grab light up a poison thing with bunch of smoke. It's toxic and everything, and everyone leaves the building, and pretty much Hollywood Hooligans is in the ring, still in there, grabbing the briefcase, and pretty much grabs the briefcase and walks out and holds the briefcase in his hand. Pretty much he won the food in the fridge briefcase. So then we had that was okay match. I have to say it was okay match, but it was disappointed in my eyes because we didn't have like Tommy Salami, we didn't have Pete Corvus, or we didn't have other people that were supposed to, we thought would be in it. Sunder Dick didn't really didn't deserve to be in it. We had somebody else in it, you know, that didn't deserve to be in it. But you know what? I have to rate this a 5 out of 5 match. I'm at 5 out of 10 match. It was an okay match, but it could have been better. The Toxic made it up to 5 match. But still. We have GTS Hardcore Championship on the line. Griffin won the championship by beating up somebody. I forgot who it was. So we have Griffin versus Alex Taylor versus Ron Voyage. And Sterling's trying to get involved in this match. Punch to face, spinning heel kick, spine buster by Ron. Ron stuffs the stuffs Griffin into the steel trash can, face to the solid steel post, knee lift to Griffin, sets chairs, puts a door on his chairs. Griffin was on the pretty much on the top of the rope, and Alex decided to get on top of the rope as well, try to do a hurricanrana, but Griffin reverses it to send Alex through the table, pretty much. And Griffin tried going for the pin, but kicked out. Griffin sets table in the corner, spinning back fist to the face. We had a cannonball. Smallwood dropped to the table by Ron. And Ron Voyage wins the Hardcore Championship, and he's a two-time belt holder right now. So Sterling decided, after raising his hand, he would pick up the roll-up pin and picks up the win. So the other ref does the same what Sterling did and pins him and wins. Punch to the face, Grimm wins. Ron wins it back. But punch to the face, Hollywood Hooligan wins. Then Griffin decides to get in there and wins it back, and he gets out of the ring and leads the GTS Hardcore Champion. You know, we could have seen this a whole lot better. We could have seen this whole show kind of sucked. I rate this whole show a 5 out of 10 match. Show. Could have been a whole lot better. The first match was good, I have to say, with the Toxic and everything. That's pretty cool to see. But, you know, this could have been a whole lot better. You could have had, like, say, I don't know. I think it just should have been better, in my eyes. I'm sorry to say. It should have been better, and there should have been, like, surprises in the ladder match, guys. It should have been surprises, not just some bullshitness, you know, in my eyes. But I'm unstoppable. Thank you for watching. Guys, stay tuned for day 6. I just hope day 6 will be excellent and interesting than this show. So, guys, please subscribe and hit that notification bell so that way you guys are notified when we upload GTS and other wrestling results. Because tomorrow, just not GTS day number 5, Grimmamania 2, it's going to be NXT TakeOver or New Orleans results for you guys. So, guys, I'll see you guys later. I'll see you guys tomorrow for GTS Grimmamania 5, or no, 6, if Grimm uploads it before 5:30, like around 4 or 3, I'll do it. That'll be okay. But if he uploads it around 5:30, I can't until pretty much after NXT is over, guys. So, I'll talk to you guys later. I'm Unstoppable, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Unstoppable out.